Steven, the city's mayor, wants to paint the world's biggest butterfly in this neighborhood, and we need some animations, renders, and the possibility to change the colors if the mayor doesn't like them. And we need all of this in less than 2 months. This was what my boss told me a few years ago when I started working in the public sector here in my city. It was my first and only task as an architect and visualizer, and I needed to solve this problem quickly. So let me tell you how we did it, how we built a city in Lumion in less than 2 months, and how the project was built at the end. So let me give you some context. Bogota is a city with a large percentage of informal construction. The government was trying to formalize this part of the city by installing aqueducts, schools, public buildings, and transportation systems, and as a final detail, painting the houses. So this goes back to a series of placemaking related projects that have been done in different parts of the world, whereby painting a neighborhood, the community gains a new identity, attracts tourism, and is transformed into a public art gallery, creating giant macro murals for the city. This was not the first time a project like this had been done. Still, it was the first time it was this big, and we had to be so precise that it was necessary to map out each house and the specific color it was going to have. And it was the first time we had to create a butterfly. Well, since the area already looked like a butterfly from afar, they said, hey, let's paint a butterfly. I was part of a bigger team composed of geographers, urbanists, and other architects. They all had different software they worked in. And the biggest challenge was getting all of this information into one rendering software. The geographers had the base information, which was our whole city mapped out in ArcGIS, with different technical information. They could give us all of this information in a CAD file, and we had to find a way to make it into a 3D model. Of course, the first option was to grab all this and model it house per house. Still, it would take an eternity to model an entire neighborhood, and in the end, we would be left with a very hefty 3D model that would crash every few minutes. We had already spent around 3 weeks and we had nothing done. It was really frustrating, and we thought it was almost impossible until one of the geographers from the team discovered City Engine, an advanced 3D modeling software for creating massive, interactive, and immersive urban environments in less time than traditional modeling techniques. Using a procedural modeling approach, City Engine supports the creation of detailed, large-scale 3D city models. Due to this unique feature set, it has been used in urban planning, architecture visualization, game development, and more. In conclusion, we were about to use software to create cities for video games for our own project. Now, the other question was, what rendering engine could we pair this up with? Which rendering program could run a heavy file and support animations, tons of renders, and many changes from one day to another? Well, you know, this was a no-brainer for us. We had decided to use Lumion for this. It was the best option if we wanted to place trees and people, change the time of day, create super cool animations, have a render-like quality, and be super easy to use. So we decided on the following workflow. First, the geographers would export the model in CAD version. We would open the AutoCAD file and decide the color of the houses and how the actual butterfly would be painted. We overlaid a little butterfly vector and started painting in each region. We created different variations of color for this, ones where we used primarily dark colors and others light colors. We would go into Google Earth, get facades from the area, cut them out, and paint them with the exact colors. We would get different variations of the front with the same color. Then the geographic team would send us a collado file with the 3D model they would create with these color variations, so we could import them into Lumion. As soon as we imported the model into Lumion, we would pair this with a satellite image in high resolution. We would adjust the scale of both and start placing the assets. Obviously, the heaviest would be all the vegetation. So I used different tools inside of Lumion where I could place hundreds of natural objects as if I were painting on paper. One of the benefits of using Lumion was that we could set hundreds of assets and still work smoothly on the project. Now, if the mayor had any modifications on the color, we would import only the houses again, but with a different color. Also, we could adjust the facade maps in Photoshop if we wanted to add graffiti or change the facade or make it larger. We also used the custom decal option to import images like graffitis on top of houses. So you would just go into effects, then go into decals, then import your custom decal, and then replace the custom decal with your image. And it was super, super easy. After doing this, we created animations to show how the butterfly would look from different perspectives. The volume cloud feature in Lumion helped us create some dramatic contrast, showing only the modeled parts, not the incomplete ones. Since this project is located on one of the most enormous mountains in the city, we had to place a lot of trees, so most of my time was spent deciding how to make the tree placement look natural. The Lumion library has been adding thousands of trees and variations of the same tree species lately, so placing different types of pines, conifers, or broadleaf trees was super easy with Lumion, obviously. And here are three tips for working on large-scale projects in Lumion. The first tip is to organize everything in layers inside of Lumion. I have the terrain in one layer, the houses in another, the vegetation in another, and so on and so forth. I cannot stress how important this is for a smooth workflow inside of Lumion. Turn the other layers off if you're working on only the vegetation and terrain. Second tip, try to use Lumion effects to your advantage. Using the volumetric light helped a lot in creating depth in the image. Also, using the tilt shift effect in aerial shots allowed the viewer's eye to focus on specific areas and hide areas that weren't necessarily finished. And being careful in using effects such as hyperlight and skylight, because they can drastically improve the quality of your images, but they can also make your render times increase a lot. So use it only in necessary images or lower the value if necessary. The third tip is to understand what is going to be close to the camera and put a lot of detail and effort into that. And for the things that are farther away, try to have them in low resolution or low poly model, so the overall file doesn't get too heavy. In this case, I used two satellite images, one from Google Earth in low resolution that I knew would be seen from far away. So there was no need to have large image files, and a high res satellite image for the project area. Also, I placed tall grass and high quality trees closer to the camera and generic conifers in the rest of the regions. Of course, after we finished this tremendous feat, everyone was amazed by the quality and realness of the images. In fact, everyone was so amazed that the actual mayor said, hey, you should make some renders and animations of the areas we plan to intervene in the next few years. So with the experience we gained from creating this model, we worked on three more projects in the following months following the same workflow. The first was a park meant to be built on the hillside of a mountainous neighborhood on the city's periphery. Here, we didn't necessarily have to paint houses, so we took this opportunity to use all the assets from Lumion to create streets and street furniture. Then our team also worked on an extensive public park along with a pedestrian street. Here, elements like moving people, features, birds, and vegetation helped represent this project better. For these projects, we also used Revit to import the specific urban design geometry and update any changes we had to make. Finally, we had to again paint more neighborhoods, but this time on a larger scale, and create entire animations from this. So needless to say, the animations, renders, and the experience was getting so much better each time we created a new project. Although it's charming to paint houses on a computer, it's better to see how communities are actually improved and real houses are painted in real life. So these were some of the pictures of how all of these interventions turned out in the end. And luckily enough, I also had the opportunity to paint one of these houses myself, although it was a lot harder than painting them in Lumion. Nonetheless, I can finally consider myself not only a digital painter, but sort of a real one too. I want to thank Lumion for sponsoring this video and letting me tell this story. When I was working on these projects, I thought to myself, you know, how cool would it be if I could tell how this was done and show it better, and if the team at Lumion found out how we used their software. Luckily, I had the chance to talk with them and they were super excited for me to tell this story. Of course, without Lumion, this whole project would not have been possible. If you want to download Lumion, there will be a link in the description. And also, if you want to see more Lumion tutorials, click on this playlist right here, which is really cool. Let me know what you thought of these projects, what things I should have done, or if you would like to see more videos like these, let me know. See you guys in the following video. Bye. Let's paint a butterfly.